Hello guys, and welcome back to another video. Today, Notion released 2.3 update. This includes the long-awaited web clipper and has a few additional tweaks to speed things up. So we're just going to give you an overview of the web clipper really briefly and also share with you some of the other news and some of my thoughts so far. So the web clipper is available on iOS, Android and Chrome. It's currently not available on Firefox. You do need iOS 11 or higher to access it and Android 5.0 to access the web clipper too. Now the simple premise of the web clipper, and they have stated a few things, you can use it to save any page, article, research, ideas, and it's very much simply going to plug into the top right hand corner of your Chrome experience. So let's get started with the web version to kick things off. So if you go to the Notion button in the top right hand corner, you can change the article title or the piece title, and you can choose the location you want to save it to. Now if you want to, you can create a links database which will create a database for you automatically. This is what a lot of people will do, and it does and is very useful because you can change the view on the database into a gallery, a list or a table, no matter what you want. Now, when you do save a link, it will automatically save that link, the image, and also text if relevant, if it's an article. You can open Notion automatically from there and be able to access it. Now, Notion have stated the Notion web clipper works best for articles or sites that are pretty straightforward, and it's highly recommended that you use it for basic articles to get started. I noticed there's a couple of issues by, for example, it double importing images, and also sometimes it didn't even capture the actual text. For example, I wanted a recipe to come in, but I can naturally imagine this is going to be a problem when we get started. It doesn't have advanced abilities like being able to add due dates, reminders, or even, for example, being able to save like a full page or an article or a simplified article like Evernote does. Now, you can use this on iOS and Android. I'm going to demo here with iOS. You can save website links when you're on Safari or even on Chrome. You just go to that share and open up the extension for Notion Web Clipper. You can move it to the front of your queue really easily, and you can start saving them. Now, one thing you can do is you can save local photos to Notion as well. So all you have to do for that is go over to your photos area and hit the share button and be able to save them into Notion. And naturally, they'll add to that new links database if that's where you chose to store it. Now, just before we dive into some of my thoughts, the other news that they did is they've updated all native apps to be opening faster and working better. And that's both offline and with a poor network connection. So that's good. I noticed a lot of you guys on the Notion Made Simple Facebook group that you're having problems actually accessing the new version, and in some cases aren't even able to log in. So I think Notion probably will be aware of that and will be fixing it. I haven't had any problems. Let me know in the comments if you have had problems. Our best recommendation is to reach out to their support team. They're super fast and the team seem really friendly. They've also changed a host of different things with some of the coding side of stuff. Other things that I want to notably highlight is you now can click links in boards and gallery cards without opening peak view, which is something very useful. For example, if you've got something saved inside of a quick access like I do, it's going to be very useful. You can also use a split screen multitasking on an iPad. They fixed that, seemed to be a problem with it. And copy pasting content from Notion on Windows preserves paragraph breaks. So that's something that's very useful and they fixed. You can check out all the fixes as well as all the information on the web clipper. There's a guide to the web clipper below just so you're aware of it. Now, my thoughts on the web clipper, I definitely think it's early days. It seems to be very clunky in terms of getting started, but I do expect that from a new experience. And the good thing is they've shipped it out. That's the most important thing. And I will start to use it over the next couple of weeks and see what I truly think. I definitely think it's a good progress, but it needs definitely fine tuning. I can see them adding more the abilities like due date adding and also reminders very soon so that you can clip pieces and you don't have to edit them afterwards. So you can get, for example, a reminder or a nudge on when you should read that article. So guys, they're also working on offline and online searches. They're coming. I can imagine see it in the next few months or at least the next month at the very least. Anyway guys, if you're new here to the Keep Productive YouTube channel, hit subscribe today. If you enjoyed this video, hit the like button. And also, if you want to comment and share some of your thoughts on the new web clipper, do below. We're always a very collaborative community, so feel free to share below. Anyway guys, thanks so much for stopping by today. Make sure to have a great week, keep productive, and I'll see you guys very, very soon. Cheers.